Hi, welcome to the channel NCERT Maths Tutor. In this video, we will discuss Class 10 Mathematics, Chapter 2 Polynomials, Introduction to Polynomials. If you like this video, please like and subscribe. Also, click the bell icon to get regular notification. So, the word polynomial has two terms. Poly means many and nomials means terms. So, polynomials together forms many terms. That means collection of many terms forms a polynomial. This polynomial is an algebraic expression which consists of variables, coefficients, constant and exponent value. Let us see what is a variable, what is a coefficient, what is a constant and exponent. So here I have taken 3x square plus 5x plus 7. So this we can call as a polynomial. As here we have this one term, then second term, then third term. So here we have three terms. So poly means many, nomial means terms. So if collection of terms or if many terms are written together, then we can call that one as a polynomial where we have variable, coefficient, constant and exponent. In this example, we have 3x square plus 5x plus 7. Now, the variable is nothing but here the x. We have here the x value that we can call as a variable. Then coefficient is nothing but the value associated with the variable. See here for x square we have the value 3. Along with x we have the value 5. So the coefficient of x square is 3 and the coefficient of x is 5. So that is nothing but the coefficient which is associated with the variable. Then we have a constant and exponent. Constant means the last value, final value, where here we are not writing any variable. This is a separate value. So here we have 7. Along with this, we are not writing any variable name. So we can call this as a constant. Then exponent is nothing but the power of the variable. See here, as I told you, x is a variable. So to this x, we have x square. So we can say that exponent of the variable x is nothing but 2. So by this way, we can have a polynomial. Let us take another example. See 4x cube plus 3x square plus 5x plus 8. Now in this case, we can have variable, coefficient, constant and exponent. Variable is nothing but x here. We have x cube, x square, x. So variable is x here. Then coefficient. See for x cube, the value associated is 4. So coefficient of x cube is 4. Coefficient of x square is 3. Coefficient of x is 5. Then the constant. 8 is known as a constant value. And the exponent value here. See for x we have the exponent power value as cube. So we can say here we can have x cube, we can have x square also. So this value is nothing but the exponent, that is the power of the variable. So here in this case we have 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 terms we have. In this case we have 3 terms. So many terms written together is known as a polynomial. And here in between these terms we can have the addition symbol or we can have the subtraction symbol. We can even have like this way 2x square minus 5x plus 8. This is also a valid polynomial. You can have a negative sign or you can have a you can have a minus sign or you can have a plus sign. That does not make any difference. So addition as well as subtraction values are allowed here. So totally in the case of polynomial, we should have variable, coefficient, constant and exponent. Then with respect to the exponent value of the variable, we have a word which is known as the degree of a polynomial. The degree of polynomial is the highest power of variable in polynomial. That means, see, in the first case we have 3x square plus 5x plus 7. Here x is the variable. The highest power of this x is x to the power 2. Because here we have x to the power 1, then the highest power is x to the power 2. That means here degree of the polynomial for this is nothing but 2, we can say. In the same way, in the second example, we have 4x cubed plus 3x squared plus 5x plus 8. In this case, highest power of x, see here we have 3, here we have 2, here we have 1. So the highest power of x is nothing but 3. So we can say the degree of this polynomial is equal to 3. So highest power of variable in polynomial is known as the degree of polynomial. Then next, in polynomial, based on the number of terms, we can have three classification. That is monomial. Suppose if the polynomial consists of only one term, then we can call that one as a monomial. Then if there are two terms, we call that one as a binomial. And if there are three terms, then we can call that one as a trinomial. Like for example, see, for monomial, I can take 5x, 4, 2y, like this way. Here actually we have, this is one polynomial, this is another polynomial, this is another polynomial. You can take here the variable name x, y, z, any name you can take, which is convenient for you, that variable name you can take. So here I have taken y also, that is also allowed. Next, even you can have just a constant, one term. This is also one term, right? So you can call this also as a polynomial, monomial this is. Next, for the binomial, we have two terms, like here in this case, 4x plus 3, 5y plus 7, 7x minus 8, you can even have a minus sign also. So here this we can call as a binomial where we have your two terms. Then we have a trinomial where we have three terms, like 3x squared plus 4x plus 2, 9y squared plus 5x plus 3, 4x squared minus 7x plus 8, like this way. So you can have plus symbol or you can have minus sign also. Addition as well as subtraction is allowed here. So this is the classification of the polynomial based on the number of terms. If you have one term, we call that as a monomial. Two terms means binomial and three terms means trinomial. So this is the introduction part of polynomial. If you like this video, please like and subscribe. Thanks for watching.